Hey guys, Corey here, CarpetmuscleTV. Getting ready to do a full house carpet stretch. Not a full house, all the upstairs. Downstairs has no carpet. Most jobs that I do not come out and look at the carpet ahead of time. This particular client needed everything done, so I stopped by on the way home from work and spent about 20-30 minutes here looking around, and I was able to tell him, you know, what I was going to need moved. And somehow, some way, before I got here this morning, got everything out of here, which is just incredible. That's what you're looking for in a client that can understand what you're saying and how the carpet's going to stretch and what needs it to be moved. It's astonishing to see the way things, I don't even know where all the furniture went, honestly. We're going to take a look around here in just a minute and show you kind of what I'm going to do it in the sequence that I'm going to do it in. But before I start, I want to say thank you to Triforce Power Stretchers. They provide a lot of the tooling that I use out here. And the one specific attachment, I've got a bunch of different Triforce tools, but no tool is more important than the one tool that I'll show you today. That's the attachment that goes on to either the crane or the Robert stretcher. It allows me to do everything I need to do without the use of poles. Some guys like to use poles, and that's fine. You can do that. I prefer not to. And almost everybody that I know of that has bought the Triforce attachment has either sent me an email or text me telling me, you know, how much they enjoy it and how much they use it. Let me go ahead and start the video here. This is the upstairs here. Stairs are fine, but where I'm going to start is right over here. Now, the first time I came through, the house had furniture everywhere in it, and I explained to them that I'm going to stretch the carpet and I'm going to go this way. Well, today they've got everything that was here, they've got it up there out of my way, which is just incredible to have that much done when you get here. So I'm gonna stretch this room this way. I'm gonna go out here, and this room is gonna go two directions. It's gotta go that way, and I'm gonna turn around, and this part, it's gotta go this way. So this guy is actually really light. It's made out of the same stuff that those other two, I don't know exactly what it's made of, but it's really light. These two guys here were sitting there, and I scooted them over there with ease. There's two more rooms over here that I'm gonna do. This room here is gonna stretch and go that way. I took everything out of here that was heavy, and I guess they fit it all in the bathroom here. It's amazing. This room here, I took everything out of here. I'm gonna stretch this room this way. And there is, I think, one more room. Yeah, right here. This guy. And we got everything out of here too. So everything that was heavy that's gonna cause issue is conveniently somewhere else. They did tell me that I'd need to use the restroom downstairs because the ones up here are full, so that is true. Oh, in the closet. I'm gonna stretch it too. All right, I'm gonna go over here. I've got some clients that, future clients that started texting me this morning that I've got to multitask. I've got to stretch this carpet, and then I've got to try to work their problems out before I arrive at their house a week or so, or 2 weeks in advance. They cut into their carpet and essentially destroy it, so I'm gonna need pieces of carpet to put their situation back together and save their carpet. Anyway, I'm gonna start right here, so I'll catch up the video at some point here, and we'll show you more. All right, one room is done here. I am not cutting any of this off until I'm done with the whole job. So basically, we got stretched off this room here. Turns out all this furniture has wheels under it, which is really convenient is wheels that actually work. Generally, wheels don't roll on carpet, but it does on this carpet. That's really odd. You know, you go to push it and it just rolls off on you. It's really weird. Very convenient, but you can see the little wheel marks where it's making, pushed it through the door. Next step is to pull all of this up here and stretch that way. I've got some cutouts here, which are inconvenient, but I believe that I won't have to even take those up. I'll be able to pull the center of the room over and leave that alone. I've had that work out for me in the past, so I don't believe I'll have to pull up anything more than those walls there, over there, to right there, and then stretch the room across. It looks like the majority of the wrinkling is kind of right in here, so that should go that way just fine. We're gonna try to divide it up half and half. And this is the tool I'm talking about from Triforce. This is what you've gotta have. It will change the way you look at carpet stretching. A lot of guys look at it and they don't think it'll work. It works incredibly well. So you can see how it works. These two guys here, they replace the poles, and you can carry it anywhere. There's nothing you can't do with this tool that you could do with poles. Anyway, over here next, got plenty of carpet to go, so I will at some point here show a little bit of stretching. Still getting warmed up here. Okay, this area here is now stretched, and it looks like it's gonna go into the hall a little bit and make me an issue of some sort. I'll have to divide up the difference and probably pull back this direction some, which is no fun because you've got a rounded wall here. Anyway, the next area, we're going to go pull the carpet the other direction. It basically all of everything here is stretched out, but you've still got loose carpet over there. You know, it would wrinkle up if I left it alone. It would wrinkle up next because this entire area here is laying limp due to probably not being stretched because of that. So, like I said, I'm gonna go pull up all of that over there. Scoot this stuff out of my way, move my tools around, and we'll see how much I stretch off of this area here. I would say quite a large bit, and the majority of the stretching will be done kind of... Phone started ringing. I was saying most of the stretching will be done kind of in the center of the room because I've got cutouts right here. So I'm not gonna wanna take that up if I don't have to. I don't think I will, being that it's going to be a lot lighter stretching in this area here, but we're moving along all right. All right, now we got the other side of the room stretched good and tight. So even though you can't see it, we are all flat in there, and we're just moving this furniture around. Slowly but surely, stretching it all out. Now I'm going to go back toward the other side of the house. I'm having to add nails here and there due to stretching against the tack strip. Anyway, let's take this over there. So yeah, I got this to deal with when I come back over here. I've got two rooms to deal with there first. And then come back over here. This guy, I was hoping I didn't have to mess with this all. We'll see how this room stretches. I may be able to alleviate what's going on in the hall. Anyway, this guy here, I am going to, I hope that's not Z-bar, but I'm going to take up the carpet all along the edges, all along here, till right there where the wrinkle's at, the last wrinkle. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. There is some stuff beyond that. I don't wanna cut the door. I don't wanna stretch that. I don't wanna do that. I don't wanna do that. I don't know what I'm gonna do. for this right here. Like I said, hopefully I can make this look good without having to actually stretch the hallway. That's kind of like a wall card and all of this. I did realize that I'm probably gonna have to stretch this closet here. That wasn't part of the original bid, neither is the hall. You know, we talked about all of this, and that's basically what the bid was put together on. So, you know, we'll play it out. You know, if it's something they want me to do, I'll certainly do it. The hallway, I'm trying to not tear into. I don't want to tear into that. I don't want to cut the carpet. I don't want to seam the carpet. I don't want to do any of that today. I want to stretch the carpet. So, now, as far as, you know, me using this guy, you got to look at it, you know, kind of like the job I'm doing today. I'm taking this from room to room. I'm not dragging poles and setting it up differently for each room that I go to. You know, I used it here. I used it over there. I used it right there, all without the use of poles and having to change up my pole arrangement. You know, if you were to measure this out, this room would go probably over, probably in excess of 30 feet from where I'm standing to over there. So you don't really want to span that far across the room with poles. And if you do, you know, it's a lot of trouble to switch gears every time you change room and take the poles with you and set them up differently. You know, with the Triforce attachment, you just take it with you, and it the math behind the thing, the way it stretches, it's pushing outward and you're stretching through. It's not pushing back. So it allows you to stretch things without poles. So works really well. All right, I'm gonna take up the carpet now, and this is what I'm gonna work on now. This guy here, making all this stretch out and look right. Be a little harder when it comes time to stretch. I'm gonna put a little stretch here and then stretch the rest of the way there. Anyway, we won't stop till we're done. I'll keep stretching. All right, I'll be back when I've got some more to show here. All right, moving along now. I did stretch the hallway, and it came out all right out into here. So I was able to kind of knock out two birds with one stone in there. At this point, probably here, I will wind up using stay nails. I'm gonna have to do quite a bit of stretching to catch up what I did here, because I had to overstretch this guy a little bit. I'm gonna have to kind of divide that out because the rest of the room doesn't need as much stretching as I did here. So I'm kind of fixing one problem and maybe creating another one right here. It's just one of those things you have to work through. You know, each one of these you do, it's kind of like putting together a puzzle. You know how to do it, and you take stuff you learned on other jobs, little tricks and stuff that you learned, and you use those same tricks here, and you keep building on that and become better and better and better at stretching carpet and being able to do things that you once thought you couldn't do. I've certainly done trickier stretching than this, but in a perfect world, doorway probably would have been cut and brought together here to deal with this area rather than pulling this through here and trying to hide it in there. Nevertheless, you know, ziggy zag, you make it work out. Only thing I am sure of now is that when I'm done, the room will be stretched and it will look well. That's the one thing that I am sure of. I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to have to do to make that happen yet. But my next step is I do see stay nails coming here and then putting a lot more stretching there. The Triforce will be used to snug it up to the wall there. And then I'll probably have a little bit, almost too much carpet right here to deal with. At any rate, next step, stay nails, little push here, and then try to even this out, I guess, kind of toward the center a little bit. Pull a little more toward the center and less toward the edges. Anyway, I'm gonna get busy. All right, just want to catch everybody up here. This guy, I'm gonna tuck this in right along here. And I've already taken the stay nails out. I put the stay nails in and I pushed the carpet over, tucked it in. So that's what you got there. Now I'm getting ready to use the Triforce and push that piece of carpet in and lock it in place, pin it in place rather. And then I think I'm gonna add a couple more nails to the rest of it because it's a pretty tight pull, but it looks like it's gonna work out just okie dokie. Yep. All right, all done here. So, two rooms left. And one closet. Got the one wall card in that room. We may opt to come back and stretch or not. I'm not sure. Anyway, I'm gonna take up the carpet along here, all the way to the doorway. Do my stretching here. The majority of the stretching will happen over here, and some will happen here, but mainly over there. Stretch right there hard enough, it'll pull this around the corner with it, and so. Anyway, this is what's next. This guy right here. I don't expect this to be that difficult. I really wish this wasn't here, this whole circular thing. That's part of the reason why this wasn't stretched tight to begin with, because it's no fun for guys to install carpet around baseboards like that. Just no, not good for stretching it good and tight. It's almost always gonna wind up getting loose later because they didn't put the cinch down on it for sure. All right, I'm gonna pick it all up here and I'll pick up the video here shortly. All right, guys, I am in the last room, not the last bit of stretching. I've got the closet to do after this, and then we decided to do the other closet. But I'm in the last full room that I'm gonna stretch here. I'm gonna go take a look at the one that I just finished up, which was the room with the curve in it. Anyway, this is your friend. This would be a good room to learn on. This is exactly what you're looking for. Either a square or a rectangle. And you take up the carpet on three sides and you stretch it across and you tuck it in and you cut it off. That is as simple as you get. It's wrinkled back to about right there. All right, I'm gonna go up here to where I just finished up. This one here had to go two directions also. If I had it to do over again, I would not go that way. I would just go ahead and tear into it and go toward the tile. I generally hate going toward the tile, but looking back now, it would have probably been easier to just go toward the tile and just get it over with. But wound up throwing a little kink into it here, stretching it all the way around here. So I had to stretch it a little bit that way to take the kink out of the carpet that happened kind of right in here. So we got it all done, but hindsight is always 20/20. No matter how long you've been doing it, you know, you'll come in and you'll look at a situation and you'll go, I don't want to do that. I don't want to mess with that today. I'm going to go ahead and do it the other way. Even though normally the other day you'd walk in here and you go, I'm not going to mess with that. Today that looked friendlier than this did. So I went that way and finished up wishing I went the opposite way. So live and learn. Live and learn. I just have to remember how this worked out next time I get into that situation. Now, this one we've added, so we're going to stretch this guy too. Not a big deal at all. It's just and you get this far along in the job and you've gotten up and down as many times as it takes to get here, one more closet sounds a little difficult. I still got to go through here and I've got to cut off all of the carpet that I've stretched. So that's going to amount to quite a bit of crawling around and cutting and then vacuuming. So I will be good to make a vacuum video for all my people that love to watch vacuum videos. And there's a few. There's a few. Go ahead and take this guy over there. And we will probably show some stretching here. And keep in mind, this stretching I'm getting ready to do is not about being in a hurry. I am not in a hurry to do this. You can do this in a hurry, but me being self-employed and at this for 20 years, if I feel like taking a break and standing and look at that picture for 10 minutes and then walk over here, look out this window for 10 minutes, it's exactly what I'm gonna do. And nobody's gonna tell me any different. So think about it that way. If you're looking for me to race through this job and show you how quickly I can use this tool, you're on the wrong channel. It's not about being in a hurry. It's about me taking my sweet time and getting done exactly when I get done. All right, I'll be back. All right, here we go. I'm going to stretch this guy out. I've got no energy at all for this right now. I've only moved these stretchers one. I placed them there, and they haven't moved even one time yet. So I'm going to be taking up all the slack with the Triforce and tucking it in and using the staple just to hold it where I want it. So now we're going to do this here. And if you'll notice, I'm wearing a shirt. Triforce on it. So, thank you, people at Triforce, Christina and Mario. Real good people. Put a couple of nails in my tack strip. That's what I need to do. It's got those little tiny wood nails in it, and I snapped one, so I got to put some nails in. So I'll be right back. All right, a few little nails here. Nail this guy back where I want it. in most of these other ones that I've done, I've kind of added nails as I went. This one, I didn't do that. I didn't add any nails. Those are my little 1-inch concrete nails. All right. Moving down. Close to the wall. You don't have to use the mini stretchers. I just like to. Tighter of a stretch with the mini stretchers due to the fact that when you're holding the carpet and you're holding the carpet tight on this side, you don't get any amount of bubbling basically behind that. Over here you've already stretched it, so when you scoot it over, this side's already tight, so you get very little pushback here. And then if you hold that side tight, you get very little pushback on the other one, so everything stays in the forward motion. It's less, you know, of the kind of the bouncing around. May be able to see some of that. I'll try to show you what I mean. First, we'll do some stretching with it, and I'll show you what I mean by let's push back. All right, we'll leave it like that. And right over here, this guy is tight right here. So from there to there, that's very tight. So we've only got a little bit of pushback there. Let me see if I can take this camera out of there without dropping it and show you what I'm talking about as far as pushback goes. So there's a little bit of pushback here. That you're gonna have a little bit of pushback with those feet. Now right over here, I'm holding it really tight right here. So you've got just about zero pushback. Now if I take the stretch out of that, if I turn that loose, you'll see pushback. Show you what I mean here. Got a little bit of pushback, but most of it was held in place by this guy here. Anyway, that's why I do what I do. Everything's being held in place right now by these two, so you don't see a whole lot of pushback. But that's why I do what I do with my mini stretchers. It's not at all necessary, but if you got them, why not use them? I started out doing this everything with a mini stretcher. And then Triforce contacted me and go, hey man, would you like to try our tools? Like, why not? Now, I don't know if I could do stretching without it. It would certainly be difficult for me to have to go through the job without him. I really enjoy using them. All right, and this guy is still holding the carpet there. He can leave it up for up to about 24 hours or better in one spot. And when you take it off, that little bump will still go back. All right, now we've got a little bit here in the corner that needs to go that way. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this guy completely out of there, and we're going to stretch it in at an angle. This is how I do all of this in my corners. So it gets pushed a little in both directions, a little bit this way and a little bit that way, just to finish out the room. Got to finish out a little over here. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish that out, and then we'll check out the closet. I've just gotta, like I said, finish this guy out here, then tuck this edge in, and that edge over there I've gotta tuck in too. So almost done with this room. All right guys, we're down to not the last closet. There's one more after this. This is what I thought was gonna be the last closet. Anyway, it's gonna go this way. This room is done. It's gonna get cut off here. As soon as I finish the other closet, around the other way. So, this one's gonna go like magic as far as you're concerned. I'm gonna take care of that and then show you the finished product. And that'll be like magic. So when I come back, that'll be done. All done. All right, that actually sucked more than I could explain. That tack strip coming up under there. And over here, it was coming up, so I had to add nails there. And then generally when you have a shelf situation like that, you can't get close enough to the wall, so you're crawling underneath there, trying not to hit your head on the shelf while you tuck everything in. So I'm still gonna come and cut this off and fight with it a little bit more, but no, that was not my friend at all. That was definitely not fun. All right, I'm gonna go look at the last closet now, and then I'll be left with mowing down all this carpet I've gotta cut off. All right, we are all done stretching. So I'm gonna go around, I'm gonna cut all of this, and we'll take one more look when I get it all cut. And that will probably have to be the end of it for today. I've been taking phone calls and text messages all day while I've been trying to work. It slows you down, but there's nobody else to do it but me. So work a little bit, then I returned a few text messages, work a little bit, returned a few text messages, and try to get people scheduled. So if I had any kind of help, it would make this go a whole lot easier. So get that over there. So anyway, I'm gonna cut all this off, and we're gonna take a look at how much carpet I took off of each wall. So that is coming up next here. All right, that is what I took off the house here. All right, guys, I am all done with another stretching job. I've got to actually stop by. I never go out and bid jobs, but it just so happened I had time to bid this job one day after work, and somebody called up that wanted stretching, cleaning, tile, and wood floors done. And I told them it'd be a couple weeks before I'd help them. They said, okay, we can wait. We kind of want to know what it would cost. They happen to live in my same neighborhood, so I'm going to pick up everything here and drive over and actually get to give them a bid on all of that. Because I certainly couldn't do all that over the phone. You know, I've got my bidding in place to do everything else where I don't actually have to see, so I don't have to see anything. There's very few jobs that I need to go out on ahead of time and look at, but it's just odd that I was in the same neighborhood as where I live, so that'll allow me to do that. And it'll be about 3 weeks before I can help him. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. God bless. I'm gonna come back and vacuum up all of this here, and then I will be done. See you guys on, I've got 3 jobs tomorrow. I maybe record about one of them.